fired up, Breathing Dragons headed to new gridiron ground recently. Carolina's semi-pro football squad now calls Knightdale High home for the fall season. And brought some familiar spring faces to the place. It was a welcoming sight indeed. The Saturday night fever pitch stemmed from the obvious. Despite a uniform snafu leaving the roster in rainbow colors, they arrived needing only a few things. Like loudspeaker hype. Like a few rival dance partners. Like one sure bet prediction. And of course, they count on enough referees. Late or not. Then it was, well, the writing was right there on the wall. As for the field, the debut began with a series of bangs. Playing devil's adversary, Jacksonville claimed the first controversial call. From this angle, the ball carrier seemed stopped short of the sticks on fourth down. Not so, according to the striped shirts. The drive had legs inside the 10. But the Red Devils were bedeviled by Butterfingers. Dominic Williams pounced on the prize possession. That mean green, though, struggled against the Red Dread defense. Allowing a long punt return to put the guest back in business. Just a hiccup for the host, since the guest again coughed up the rock.
Bubble on the play.
Montage of motion back and forth kept the combatants on an even plane.
Hey,
Until Carolina bashed and churned out a tenacious turf trick. Reaching as far as the one. Fourth down. After a false start penalty, Trey Baker was the maker of his namesake via a 23-yard field goal. Baker then collected his comm and kicked off. Dragon D continued loosening Red Devils' grips. So Williams could scavenger hunt the pigskin prey. Carolina subsequently supersized its search for success front and center. QB Tariq Robinson roamed the range, aided by an uplifting block, a 48-yard Trey try, though, was sabotaged at the snap. Though Raymond Farmer safely squashed any late half heroics by the visitors. In the third quarter, the Dragon Herd cornered Jacksonville after the Red Devils ventured into the red zone. The adrenaline was flowing. Carolina was pumped. So Robinson lofted this fly route to Tyler Chapman. Chapman found the ball and wound up with it, no matter what the devil on his shoulder argued. Ben Robinson bought space to laser beam Jamal Curtin amid the Red Devil Triangle. This trip concluded with Baker's post-parter from 38 yards away. Can't block this. Another bobble was gobbled up by Williams. But misfortune accompanied the fourth period.
Hey, hold on. Hey, you gotta let those scrubs get out of our huddle. Hold on, let those scrubs get out of our huddle.
Williams' chase and chop of the rival Devil Rifle. And a dud of a bomb maintained Carolina's razor edge margin. Kendrick Ford demonstrated the fighting spirit and the enabled body assist to keep mowing yards. Robinson again located Curtin.
Go get it, bro.
and you can quote me when I assure you that insurance was just not meant to be.
Oh, hit it. Look up, bro.
Especially when the line judge refused to state the obvious. This toter's only progress went backward from the get-go. Caroline, in fact, allowed nothing positive to happen.
It wasn't dirty, bro. I did a straight up tackle.
I just realized that.
As the Atlantic Coastal Football Association squabble droned on.
Slide over here. Bring it right here. Run that bitch, boy.
The Dragons slipped into position for a clinching Baker boot from 48 yards.
Let's look at the scoreboard.
6-0.
CK, don't you listen to
sadly.
Chill out, chill out, chill out.
But we coming back.
But not quite. Neither would the Red Devils exit quietly. Consecutive late hit and interference curses versus Carolina caused a heck of a lot of trouble. The latter sure looked more like an almost interception instead. There would be absolutely no doubt about Quan Batts' acting discipline. This dragon almost dismembered this dude. Prior to Justin Chavis breaking up this pass. Followed by Demetrius Council's broken heart kick on Jacksonville's last gasp. The Dragons were over the moon, which was hanging over them, with an undefeated 2-0 mark and an unscored upon resistance so far. This is Don Fuller, East Wake Television.